Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to quickly install Kali Linux on VirtualBox using the pre-built virtual machine. If you're looking for a fast and hassle-free way to run Kali Linux, this method is perfect for you. So first, you need to install Oracle VirtualBox. If you have not installed VirtualBox yet, you can check the link to my previous video in the description. Okay, you can follow the steps accordingly and then come back here. After that, open your browser and you need to go to the official Kali Linux website, which is kali.org. And here you can see Kali Linux is an open source Debian based Linux distribution. And here you need to simply click on download for the latest version. Okay, so now you need to choose your platform from here. In my earlier video, I showed you how to install Kali Linux using the installer image, but today I will guide you through a much easy process. Okay, we will be downloading virtual machine specially designed for VirtualBox. So no installation headaches this time. Okay, so simply click on virtual machine and choose the 64-bit version unless you are running an older PC, which is 32-bit system. Okay, then select the VirtualBox and click the download button in the bottom left corner of the virtual box and your download should start automatically. And you can see it's around 3.1 GB of size, so this might take a few minutes depending on your internet speed. I have already downloaded this file earlier, so I am going to cancel the downloading process here. But once you finish downloading, you will get the file in .7zip format. Okay, you can use 7zip or any similar tools like Winrar to extract it. Okay, so for that, right click on the file, then click on extract all. Depending on your system, extracting the file may take a few minutes. Be patient if it's a bit slow. Okay, after extraction, you will get folder name Kali Linux 2024.3 VirtualBox AMD64, and so you need to double click on it and you will find two files under this. You need to look for the blue file type, which is VirtualBox machine, which is only 3 KB. Okay, so later we need to use this file for the process. And after that, open your Oracle VirtualBox on your PC. Once it open, click on the green add button and then navigate to the downloaded folder and select the extracted VirtualBox machine file. This is the pre-built VM, okay? And immediately VirtualBox Manager will open and in the left side, see the Kali Linux virtual machine is ready. You can see from here. If you want, you can customize the virtual machine settings like increasing the RAM or CPU cores, but it's not required since everything is already set by default, okay? And you can use it as is, okay? Once everything checked, it's time to start the VM and install Kali Linux on it. So for that, click on the start button and you will see the virtual machine is powering up. So no need to do anything here, it will handle everything automatically. In my earlier video, we had to go through several steps like selecting the grub bootloader, creating partition and other installation process, but here's the best part, you don't need to do anything. This pre-built virtual machine is already configured. It will boot up automatically and everything will be ready to go on its own. After that, you will see the login screen. You can use the default credential, which is Kali, in both the username and password field. And after that, you need to click on login. Congratulations, you now have Kali Linux running on your Windows 11 machine using VirtualBox. So now you need to take some time to explore this new environment and also start exploring the pre-installed tools. And you can click on the root terminal emulator and immediately it will ask for your authentication password. Okay, so don't worry, the default password is Kali. Just type it in and press enter. Now that the terminal is open, let's update the system. So for that, you need to type apt space update. This command will start checking for any software updates, okay? Next, if you want to update all the installed software, then you need to type one command, which is apt space upgrade. This will upgrade any outdated packages on your system. Just follow the on-screen prompts and press Y if it asks for confirmation. Okay. And then if you want to make this full screen, click on View in the toolbar, then select Full Screen. Then click on Switch and it will expand to cover your entire screen. Okay. So that's it for today, guys. You now have Kali Linux running on your VirtualBox. I think it's very easy and quick way to get started without having to install every step from scratch. So what do you think, guys? Please leave your comments below. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you are new here, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any future video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.